Yassin Nasser, who did make it to Ivory Coast, says that he had a plan of debuting his newly acquired car at the Bandama Rally in Cote d'Ivoire after the Mbara Rally, but because of the logistical challenges, he couldn't make it on time.
As we spoke earlier, that we are ready now for the first event. Unfortunately, we didn't make it to Ivory Coast because of logistic issues. And now we are well prepared. After doing the Mbarara Rally, we had to strip the car again, and we found some things needed to be changed because the mechanics from Karan Patel came in and helped us to set up the car. We've tested after this several times, and I think we are ready for the event. The car is ready, the team is ready to go for it. We don't know about the speeds are going to be there, but as usual, we are going for competition, so we will do best as what we can do as a crew in the car, and keep the car on the road as much as possible.
He goes ahead to claim to have made a wise decision, since it seemed hard for many foreign crews to transport their rally cars from Cotonou to Abidjan, and also acquiring one in Cote d'Ivoire was pretty more expensive, equating it to buying another new car.
The values, and approved the values to proceed, so we were 80% ready to go, and everything was prepared. But when we got the invoice, it was like we were going to buy another Nemo. So it was not worth it to spend that amount of money again going across. But we still had an opportunity to hire a car. But again, the cost of hiring a car was as is again buying a car.
He notes that switching intentions after Mbara Rally was to basically get enough seat time as he masters the car.
We realized after we did Machakos event, we needed more seat time. And to master the car, we need more seat time. And having the seat time, it means we need to do more events than the training sessions. So that is why we reverted back and said, wherever we'll be able to go, we shall go. But the NRCs in Uganda would be the easiest and one way of to spend so much money to go out in terms of expenses. That's why we decided that let's do the NRCs as well, so that we can have more seat time with the car.
Yassin has only participated in one event out of Uganda, and that was Machakos Rally. However, the soft-spoken rally driver believes was an eye-opener for them of what ought to be done.
I wouldn't judge myself at the moment, I think, but we have good chances because we've become a bit quicker. The Kenyan drivers are experienced, they have driven in those terrains before. We have also driven in the same terrains, but we had a different car. So again, there's a difference between having driven in the same terrain and with a different car.
Now that Tim Moyle knows the logistical challenges for the ARC, Yassin suggests he will give the championship another year when he's able to transport the car early enough by sea.
If we decide to do another season for ARC, because it's too early to talk about them now, we already know what are the logistic challenges, right? So basically, the cheapest way to drop your car is by sea.
Yassin Nasser and Jess Manga to represent Uganda at the second round of the African Rally Championship in Kenya this weekend. The representing crews will be opening their accounts in the race for the African Rally Championship title after missing out on the first round in Cote d'Ivoire last month. Both Yassin and Mangat have previously had success in Continental Championship, coming out as champions in the ARC title, a category for the Group N cars. Yassin won in 2021, while Mangat is the reigning category champion. The crews will be battling for the ARC points with Kenyan crews of Karen Patel, Aikif Virani, Piero Konobio, among others. This year's Equator Rally moved from Naivasha to Voi near the Indian Ocean coast.
And that is all I ask of the local organizing committee. A team does not need to be perfect, it needs to be united. And united, we will be. We will not let you down.
Joni Sempija, reporting for the New Sport.